आई राम टू ऑल। इन दिस फर्स्ट चैप्टर रियल नंबर द थर्ड कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर गेटिंग एंड ऑन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर गेटिंग द क्वेश्चंस इन द बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन एंड डैट क्वेश्चंस आर ऑफ 2 मार्क्स और 4 मार्क्स। फॉर दिस रीजन दिस थर्ड कॉन्सेप्ट बेस्ड ऑन एक्सरसाइज 1.3 इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट वी हैव वी आर रिवाइजिंग ई रैशनल नंबर। वी आर फैमिलियर अबाउट ई रैशनल नंबर। Those numbers in simple definitions we are saying this, those numbers which are not rational are called irrational. Numbers which are not rational are called irrational. Here we have some example: root 2, root 3, 3 root 2, 5 under root 3. The combination of rational and irrational, we are also considering this one in this presentation. Here we have 5 minus root 3, where it is rational or irrational. Then if root 3 is rational, then we are familiar with the terms. So what we are getting when we are adding or subtracting the rational and irrational values. Then in simple definition in class 9th, we are also familiar with this term, that numbers which are non-terminating and non-recurring. The non-terminating and non-recurring numbers are called irrational numbers. These definitions we have in class 9th. And here I am showing the value of pi 3.14592653 5 and so on. And this value is also non-terminating and non-recurring. For this reason, this value pi is irrational. Same, we have a Euler number that we are representing by small e. This is also an irrational value. And the third one I am taking golden ratio. We are representing this value and this one is also an irrational number. And the square root of prime number. The square root of prime numbers are always irrational. All these concepts we know. And here we have the concept of class 10th, the sum or difference of a rational and an irrational number. The sum or difference of a rational and an irrational number is always irrational. Suppose I am taking an example. I am taking here 3 plus root 2. If I am adding 3 plus root 2, we are getting 3 plus root 2. In the second one, 2 minus root 3 means all these three values which I am getting on the screen are irrational. And what we are doing here, we are getting the sum and the difference. We are taking the sum and difference of rational and irrational value. And when we are doing this, we are always getting an irrational value. The same concept we have for product and the quotient. The product and quotient of a non-zero rational and irrational number is always irrational. The product and quotient of a non-zero rational and irrational is always irrational. Here I am taking an example. I am multiplying an irrational value root 3. This we are proving in the further session, whether root 3 is rational or irrational. I am telling this root 3 is an irrational value, and if you are multiplying with a rational value 2, we are getting 2 root 3. In the another example, if I am multiplying 4 root 5 and 5 root 3, 4 root 5 and 5 root 3, the rational is multiplied with rational. 4 into 5 we are getting 20 here, and root 5 into root 3 we are getting 15, means 20 root 15. And 20 root 15 is also an irrational value. Then here I am showing this, if you are multiplying a rational value and an irrational value, always we are getting an irrational value. I think the concepts are clear. Then on the basis of these concepts, this you have to remember, if you are adding any rational and an irrational value, always we are getting an irrational value. If you are subtracting a rational and irrational, we are getting irrational. If you are multiplying rational, irrational, we are getting irrational. And same for the division. means the sum, the difference, the product and the quotient of a rational and a an irrational value is always an irrational. All these concepts we have already read in class 9th. In class 10th, we are going to prove theoretically all these concepts. When we are adding a rational and irrational value, always we are getting irrational value. This we are going to show in class 10th. In the further presentation, we are going to solve this. Here I have some questions. The first question I am taking, the sum of two rational number. If you are adding any two rational, suppose I am adding 2 and 3, then I am getting 5, and 5 is a rational number. The second one I am taking, the product of two rational number is always a rational. Third one is the sum of a rational and an irrational is always an irrational value. And the fourth one, I am taking the product of non-zero. This we have done further in this presentation. The product of a non-zero rational and irrational is always irrational. And the product of two irrational numbers. Suppose I am multiplying root 2 with root 2. Then what I am getting? Root 2 square is 2. And this I am getting as rational value. But when we are multiplying 2 and root 2, then we are getting 2 root 2. And this value, 2 root 2, is an irrational value. For this is the fifth one I am taking, the product of two irrational number is irrational and rational. Then here we have the first question. And this question I am taking from your NCERT book. The example I am taking, this one is the theorem, also theorem 1.4 we have to show root 2 is irrational. Then this we have to show, for proving this value is irrational. This we know, root 2 is an irrational value, but we are going to show this. And if we have to show this, then we have to take an assumption. We are taking a contradiction, and here I am taking the contradiction as root 2 is a rational value. And if it is a rational value, then the rational numbers, we know the rational numbers are in the form p upon q, and where the denominator is not equal to 0, and that too p and q, though both the values are co-prime number, means the SCF we are getting as 1. Means suppose a fraction is given, you have this value 4/6. This is also in the form p upon q, but it is not a rational number, it is a fraction. And what is the reason? Because we are observing 2 is the common factor between these two, other than 1. If you are solving this, if you are dividing these two value by 2, we are getting this 2/3. Now this value is rational. 2/3 is rational, where 4/6 is an fraction. It is a fraction. Then here also we are taking root 2 is equal to r/s. Here I am taking this value. Root 2 I am taking as r/s, and if I am getting any factor other than 1, common factor we are getting, then we have to divide that 2 value by that common factor. And then what we are getting? We are getting a simplified value, means the rational number we are getting from the fraction. And always this you have to remember, always when we are taking rational, then that two value, suppose I am taking a rational as a upon b, then a and b always are co-prime, means the SCF is 1. Then what we are observing here, if we are taking this value, root 2 is equal to a upon b, then on cross multiplying we are getting this, a is equal to b root 2. And if you are making the square on both sides, we are getting 2b square is equal to a square. Then what does it mean? 2b square is equal to a square. If you are taking 2 on the other side, then you are getting 2 in the division. It means that 2 divides a square. And by theorem 1.3, if 2 divides a square, then it should divide a also. This concept you have to remember. If any value divides the square, then that value also divide the value, the same value also. For example, suppose I am taking a number 9. And 9 is a square of 3 and it is also divisible by 3. The same concept we are using here, because in this we are observing 2 divides a square, then it should divides a. And if 2 divides a, then we are able to write this a equal to 2c. We are able to write a equal to 2c. What is c? For example, suppose I am taking 6, the number 6 I am taking, and if 6 is divisible by 3, this we know. If you are dividing 6, then what we are getting? We are getting the remainder 0. Means 6 can be written as 3 into 2. The same concept we are using. A is equal to BQ plus R. We are using the same concept. A is equal to BQ plus R. If you are putting the value, then we are getting 6 is equal to 3 into 2 plus 0, because the remainder you are getting 0. And 6 is equal to 3 into 2 plus 0. If you are not writing this 0, then we are getting 6 is equal to 3 into 2. Similarly here, what we have, A is divisible by 2. Means we are getting the remainder 0. For this reason I am taking 2c. Means quotient I am taking here. Quotient I am taking c. And the divisor we have 2. Divisor we are taking 2. I think now this statement is clear. Why we are writing a equal 2c. This concept is very important. And a simple concept we have. When we are dividing the value, when we are getting the remainder 0. And if you are writing in the form dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, then we are getting this, because the remainder is 0 here. And then if you are substituting this value in the first equation that we are getting, then we are getting 2b square is equal to 4c square. Because we are getting this 2b square equal to a square we are getting. And if you have, we have the value of a at 2c. And if you are putting the value, we are getting 2b square is equal to 4c square. And on simplifying, we are getting b square is equal to 2c square. Then again, what does it mean? If you are taking 2 on the other side, then this we are getting 2 divides b square. And if 2 divides b square, then it should divides b. Then what we are observing here, in this step, in the first step, we are getting 2 divides a, here we are getting 2 divides b. It means that 2 is the least common factor of these two, a and b. 2 is the least common factor of a and b. And what we have the definition in the rational number, if you are taking the rational number in terms p upon q, then these two are always co-prime number. means we are not getting any other factor other than 1. Here we are getting 2 as the common factor. It means that if you are writing under root 2 equal to a upon b, means this is contradiction. This is contradiction, and because we are getting one more factor other than 1, we are getting here the 2 as the common factor between a and b. And if 2 is the common factor between a and b, it means that a upon b that we are taking is not a rational number. And this contradiction has arisen, and due to our incorrect assumption, we are saying root 2 is always an irrational number. This is the contradiction, because we are assuming this root 2 is equal to a upon b, and here we are showing this a and b are not coprime. For this reason, we conclude that root 2 is always an irrational number. Then let us take one more question from your NCERT. We have to prove this 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational number. Here we are observing the sum of rational and irrational value. This also we know, this is an irrational value, and this we are going to prove. Again, for proving this, we have to take assumption as per the last question we have done. And if you are assuming this, then let us assume that 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational. And if it is rational, then we are able to write 3 plus 2 root 5 is equal to a upon b. And if you are taking 3 on the other side, we are getting the concept a upon b minus 3 is equal to 2 root 5. And if you are taking the LCM between these two, because 3 can be written as 3 upon 1, then this we are getting. And if you are taking 2 on the other side, the next step we have under root 5 is equal to a minus 3b upon 2b. First you have to take LCM. If you are taking LCM, b is the LCM, then in the numerator we are getting a minus 3b. Then we are taking this 2 on the other side. And if you are taking 2 on the other side, 2 is in the multiplication here, then we are getting that value in the division. For this reason, the fraction we are getting a minus 3b upon 2b is equal to under root 5. And what we are observing here? Here we are observing a and b are integer. It means that if these two values are integer, then this value must be rational. A minus 3b upon 2b is rational. But what we know, root 5 is an irrational value. Means this is contradiction. Because we know this a minus 3b upon 2b is rational, where root 5 is an irrational, and an irrational cannot equal to a rational value. This is contradiction. For this reason, we are able to tell this our assumption is wrong. 3 plus 2 root 5 is always an irrational value. This is clear to all. A minus 3b upon 2b is rational, and root 5 is also rational. But this is contradiction, because root 5 is always an irrational value. For this reason, rational cannot equal to, this also we have to add in the statement, a rational cannot equal to an irrational. Rational value never be equal to an irrational value. Then when we are writing the statement, for writing the statement we are getting 1 or 2 marks in these kinds of question. Then this you have to add. If you are adding this one, then half marks you are getting. Then here I am taking another question. We have to prove this root 3 plus root 5 is irrational. This also we know, the sum of two irrational value is always an irrational value. This time in the board examination also we are getting this question of 4 marks. We have the value and we have to show the sum of two irrational is always an irrational value. Then again the same concept we are following. If we are taking the contradiction, this value is a rational value, and if it is a rational value, then this value is equal to p upon q, where p and q are co-prime integers. And if this value is equal to p upon q, then because both the values are irrational, in the last question what we are doing there, we are taking the rational value on the same side and we are leaving the irrational on one side. Here we are, both the values are irrational, for this reason we have to make the square first. And when we are making the square, we are getting this step, root 3 plus root 5 whole square, then a plus b whole square, we know a square plus b square plus 2ab. And here we are getting in the right hand side p square upon q square. Then the same concept we are following, we are taking the rational value on one side and we are leaving the irrational value on one side. Then 3 plus 5 we are getting 8. If you are taking 8 on the other side, we are getting minus 8 here. And 2 is in multiplication with root 15. We are taking LCM first. Here q square is the LCM. And in the numerator we are getting p square minus 8q square. And in the next step what we are doing, we are taking 2 on the other side, then we are getting root 15 is equal to p square minus 8q square upon 2q square. Again what we are observing here, in the last step we are getting root 15, and root 15 is clearly, it is an irrational number where this value is a rational number. Means again we are getting the contradiction here. Our assumption is wrong because we are taking the given value is rational, but what we are observing, in one side we are getting a rational value, but in the other side we are getting an irrational value. And the concept we know, rational cannot be equal to an irrational value. For this reason our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is wrong and root 3 plus root 5 is always an irrational number. Now here we have some questions on from exercise 1.3. 3 questions are given. And second question we have already done. You have to do question of first and third. And remember one thing. When we are proving these questions, when we are solving these questions are of 2 marks. These questions are of 2 marks. All these questions are of 2 marks which we are observing on the screen. And take the rational value on one side and keep the irrational on the other side. And at last use the concept, rational can never be equal to an irrational value. For this reason the total value is an irrational value. And from here, if you are getting 2 irrational value, then that question is of 4 marks. Sai Ram to all.